Gardeners, welcome to another video on my channel. For anyone that's new, my name is Trisha, and in today's video, we're going to be talking about why reptiles make terrible Christmas presents. So this is the perfect timing to make a video like this because obviously Christmas is around the corner. It is now December. So I really wanted to make this video because it's so important, and a lot of the times when holidays roll around, obviously Christmas is the number one gift-giving holiday. People tend to think that buying other people animals is a great gift, and there are many reasons why this is terrible, and this goes horribly all the time. So it's just something I really wanted to talk about. So in this video, I was able to come up with 5 reasons why I think that reptiles make terrible Christmas presents, and I really apologize if you hear crickets. They're very loud, and I'm sorry. I know that bothers a lot of you guys. I'm like so used to it, I just tune it out, so if it bothers you, I'm sorry. I don't know what else to do. So the number one reason why reptiles can make terrible Christmas presents, it has to do with how you're going to be getting the animal in the first place. So depending on where you live, if you're ordering a reptile online, there are some pretty awful companies out there that really don't care about the well-being of the animal. And if you live in a place where it's cold and it's winter time and you're looking to buy a reptile, they may ship it anyway, and they may not ship it in the best conditions, and it's just not safe for the animal. So a lot of the times people will receive dead animals. So that's obviously not a good thing. That's not something I want to see. So that's something to be aware of. The other thing that people do a lot of the time is they're not familiar with reptiles. They're just going to buy one for someone for Christmas, and they go to a pet store like Petco or PetSmart. And you guys know I never recommend buying any reptiles from there just because they come in such terrible condition. You really don't know what you're gonna get. A lot of the times they have health issues and they're just not in great condition. So that's not something that I recommend doing. And I noticed that that is the number one place where people that have not kept reptiles go to buy reptiles. So that's just another thing that I don't wanna see in this Christmas season. Now, there are people that do it the right way. If you are an experienced reptile keeper, you know to go to a reputable source, you go to a reptile show, whatever the case may be, there is a responsible way to do it. But for the people that are new to reptile keeping, I've seen them do a lot of these things the wrong way, whether it's shipping in really bad weather conditions or going to a really crappy store and just getting an animal that's not going to thrive. So that's the first reason why I think that getting a reptile for Christmas can be problematic in certain situations. The second issue that I have about people buying reptiles as Christmas presents has to do with the fact that it's more of like an impulse buy. And if you're purchasing an animal for someone else, depending on how long you plan to be keeping the animal before you give it to the person, you could have just bought it within the day and you plan to give it to the person within the next day or so. But there can be an issue with this, especially if you don't have everything provided for the animal when you're purchasing it. For any reptile that you'd be purchasing, it's best to have the full enclosure completely set up before you even bring it home. That way, when you do bring the animal home, it has time to adjust and settle into its new environment. Because being in a store or wherever it may have come from and then traveling and going to a completely new environment can be very, very stressful for reptiles. So it's the best thing to do is to always have their enclosure completely set up when you bring them home. And for people that are buying them for someone else, they may not be putting all of that money in and buying them everything that they need. A lot of the times they'll rely on the person that's receiving the gift to supply everything that the animal needs, and they're just buying the animal as a gift. So a lot of the times in those cases, the animal is just like sitting in a box for a long time or just not in good conditions. It's not getting the temperatures, the humidity that it needs. And it's also just very stressed out and just not in a new place where it can settle in because you're waiting to give it to someone. So in that type of a situation, it can be very problematic and stressful for the animal. And it's just not fair to the animal. And again, for the people that are familiar with all of this and keep reptiles and they're getting a reptile for their friend for Christmas, maybe they bought everything and they have the enclosure fully set up so that way the animal can relax and adjust while you're waiting to give it as a gift, then I could see it being okay. But a lot of the times that's not how this goes. The third reason why I think buying reptiles as Christmas gifts can be problematic is when I see people, and this doesn't even count like just for Christmas, this happens all of the time, no matter what time of the year it is, parents go to pet stores and they buy an animal for their kid, and because maybe the kid really wants it, and maybe the parent is trying to teach their kid responsibility. So they buy them this animal so that way the kid can take care of it, and they kind of treat it like it's a disposable thing. So I see a lot of the times parents will just buy an animal for their kid and they just expect the kid to fully take responsibility and take care of that animal. And if it doesn't work out, it doesn't work out, and they don't really care. And that is just really, really depressing and sad. And it's just a huge lack of respect for the animal. Like, it's a living creature. You should not be bringing it into your house unless you know that it will be fully taken care of. And that's not a responsibility that should be put on a kid's shoulders. It's unfair to the animal. So if you are going to be doing this, if you're a parent and you want to get a reptile for your kid, there's absolutely nothing wrong with it as long as you are still going to be taking care of that animal completely. You can teach your child how to take care of it. You can provide everything that it needs. You should not just buy an animal and expect a child to do everything for it, especially because you don't know, maybe the child hasn't done any research. I mean, it's a child. So you can't really put the responsibility of a living creature on a child. It's just unfair to the animal. And a lot of the times, I just hate seeing parents do this, and they just don't really know anything about the animal. They don't care. They think they're just making their kid happy. And if it dies, they just don't care. And that's just something I want to see change. So obviously it happens at Christmas. It happens all the time throughout the year. It's just something that I hate and I don't want to see it happen. So if you're going to be buying a reptile for your kid for Christmas or whatever the case may be, and you're a parent, make sure that you will be taking responsibility of that animal, because it is a living creature and it deserves everything that it needs. And at the bare minimum, just some respect at the very least. So the number four reason that I have why buying a reptile can be a terrible Christmas present is, one, kind of if you are getting the present for someone and they're completely unaware and they haven't done any of the research for this animal and they just may not even want it in the first place. Obviously, that's a really, really bad situation. But maybe the person did express that they want this animal, but again, they haven't done research and they don't have the money maybe to take care of it, to get it everything that it needs. These kind of situations just are very irresponsible when it comes to buying a present for someone, because when you're keeping reptiles, they do require having a lot of knowledge and even experience when taking care of them, just to make sure you're doing everything correctly. It requires a passion, and if the person is lacking the passion or the interest in like researching the animal and how to take care of it, then the animal's going to end up suffering, and that's just not fair to the animal. And people also don't realize that reptiles live for a long time. They are a very big commitment, and sometimes when you're gifting this to someone, it can be more of a burden than a gift, because it requires a lot of work, and if the person really isn't interested in all of that, it's not going to work out for them or the animal, and then it just makes a completely terrible Christmas gift in the end. And the number five reason that I have why reptiles make terrible Christmas gifts is impulsively buying reptiles in general. So whether you're doing it for a gift or whatever the case may be, if you just walk into a pet store and you think, oh, you know what, my friend would really like this chameleon, I'm gonna get it. You just need to do more thinking than that. You need to really understand everything that this animal is going to need. Make sure it's all going to be provided for. If this is just done in an irresponsible way, it's just so detrimental to the animal, and it's not fair to the animal. So it's just a matter of knowing your stuff, showing respect for the animal and the person that you're giving it to. And I just want to see less people get animals that they don't really want, or maybe get animals that they don't know how to take care of, and then the animal suffers. It's just the worst thing of all time. It's the one thing I really hate about the hobby, and I want to see it change. So that's why I'm making this video. So if you're thinking about buying a reptile for someone for Christmas, I really hope that you think twice about it. If you know exactly what you're doing and you're familiar with keeping reptiles and you know the person you're giving it to has really wanted this reptile and has everything that they need to take care of it, then the situation can work out. But most of the time, that's not how this goes. So that's why I'm making this video, because I just don't want to see these situations. It really sucks for the animals in the end. And it's not a good way to celebrate Christmas. I think, honestly, if you're looking for a good Christmas gift for someone that really likes reptiles, the best thing to do is either get them reptile books so that way they can do more research and learn more about them. Because honestly, it may sound like a boring gift, but I love reptile books. Like, I collect them. It's so much fun. And anyone that's really into reptiles should love that type of a gift. So that's something to consider. Another thing to consider if you want to get someone a gift who loves reptiles, if they're already keeping reptiles, the best thing that you could do is get them gifts for their reptiles. And that may sound strange, but one of the best things about keeping reptiles, especially for me, is spoiling my animals. So whether you're buying them some plants, some fake plants, ledges for eating, hiding places, even a gift card to a pet store so they can get some insects or whatever the case may be, that is like an amazing gift and it'll go a long way, especially for reptile keepers. Like, I'm always so happy when I just get a gift card and I can just spoil my animals some more. And I know that my friends are the same exact way, so it's definitely something to consider, and it's much easier, less responsibility than just giving someone a straight up animal, which is so much commitment and so much responsibility. So I hope that this video was helpful. If you are considering buying someone a Christmas gift that's a reptile, please reconsider. Just be aware of all of this. Make sure you're making the best decision. And I hope that you guys all have an amazing Christmas. But I just wanted to make this video kind of earlier because I don't know when people are planning to start buying animals for Christmas. So I kind of just wanted to avoid that. But hopefully this video was helpful for you guys. I appreciate you guys watching this video. Thank you guys so much, and I will see you guys in the next one.